Last class I was teaching you what is computer, isn't it? I hope that is clear to you. Computer is an electronic machine. I'll just go very fast with you. Computer is an electronic machine which takes data through input device, processes it, and generates the output. Okay. So, and we have studied about the full form of computers also. As I told you, all my students should know what the full form of computers. Commonly operating machine, particularly used for technical education and research. This we studied last class. Then we studied what are the four important things that a computer does. What a computer does, that is why it differs from any other machine. Computer can take the input, process it, store it, and gives us the output. It can give us the output, it can store the information. So this no machine does. So that is why computer is different from other machine. I hope it is clear. Then we studied what is input device. Input device is used to take input from the user. Then after taking the input, whatever we give, whatever instructions that we give is taken as the input. So we have so many input devices such as keyboard, mouse, camera, mic, joystick, barcode reader. So many things that we'll learn in the coming section only. So input device is actually used to input data. What is the use of input device? It is actually used to input data and instructions. We can give proper data and instructions through the input device. This also I taught you last class. Now, then I told you about the IPO cycle. Computer functions with the IPO cycle. What is the IPO cycle? Input, process, output. You can put an S also, IPOS, which is input, process, output, and save. So here what happens is, even a slight input that we give is converted into ones and zeros, that is happening inside. Then after that, the input device convert into ones and zeros, sent to the processor. After what happens, it processes it and then sends it to the output device. Then we can store also. We have a memory to store. We can make it as IPOS, which is input, output, input, process, output, and storage. Input, process, output, and storage. Now, so the IPO cycle is input, process, output, and I told you we can put an S if you want so that we can save also. That also computer does. In your text it is only given IPO cycle. I have put an S also. We can save because computer does that too. So it is input, process, output, and save. Now that I have taught you in the last class, then I have taught you about the keyboard also, isn't it? Which is the primary important input device. What is the use of keyboard? We can type in, we can type all the necessary instructions, we can do the scrolling of screen, then we can type in letters, everything can be done using a keyboard. Keyboard allows us to input numbers, everything. There are so many keys there. And I've told you about the keyboard also. There are control keys, function keys, navigation keys, numeric keys, and indicator keys. I'll do one thing. I'll share this. You have to mark where all this is, where the number key is, where the function key is. I'll share this particular picture. So you have to mark it where all this is. Understood? I've given this. So mark it and send it to me. That is the assignment today. I'll send it to you. Now the next is, there are different types of keyboards, which is wireless keyboards, multimedia, and portable keyboards. We know that some keyboards are wireless, which is available nowadays. Even we have keyboards like this also here. See? Are you seeing it? So this is a wireless one. We can just type in and see. See? It has jumped up. So we have such types of keyboards too. So wireless keyboard, multimedia keyboard in one touch access. That's what we are seeing here. Kind of one touch access, it is coming. Okay. Now, then we have portable keyboard, something which we can carry. like you are very small piece keyboards which we can carry. We have portable keyboards also which are called PDAs. In our mobiles we have keys, isn't it? We can type in. So they are all portable keyboards which comes along with the mobile phones. So wireless ones, multimedia which is one touch I've shown you now, and we have portable keyboards that we carry in our mobile phones when we type in, isn't it? You will send messages to your friends. I hope you do that. So if you are not doing, do it. Now latecomers are not allowed. Understood? Okay. Stop doing all the mischiefs. If I see anybody doing it, you'll get it, I'm telling you. Stop doing all the mischiefs. Now, what is a pointing device? Mouse. I have told you last class also. I know that it will be a bit boring if I repeat the same, but still, I just want to continue with the old portion. I know that you haven't revised it. Mouse is discovered by whom? Douglas Engelbert. Who discovered mouse? Douglas Engelbert. He discovered the mouse in which we have two buttons and we have a scroll wheel in the middle. That I've told you, isn't it? Mouse is a very important graphical device in which we have two buttons and a scroll wheel. What is the use of scroll wheel? We can make the page up and down using the scroll wheels. We can move the page up and down, and we have the right button and the left button that you all know. When you click onto the right button and the left button, what happens? Something pops, isn't it? When you click onto the icon and when you click onto the left mouse button, what happens? Something pop up. Yes or no? Then we have the right mouse button to point to a device, everything that you have already done. I point to an icon, we have a button. If you want to pop, when you click on to the left mouse button, things pop up, everything happens. So that is what is the use of mouse button. We have a two buttons and a scroll button in the middle which is used to scroll the page up and down. Now scroll mouse. Now I think this I have not taught you last class. From now on, we'll go very slow. Mouse with a rubber or a plastic wheel located between the left button and the right button, the scroll wheel, is also known as a wheel mouse. So we have the scroll mouse or the wheel mouse in which we have the button in between the right and the left button that I've already told you. And when this wheel is moved back and forth, the active window is scrolled. We can scroll with this, we can make the page go up and down. Understood? So, and it is again divided. This scroll mouse is again divided into optical mouse and wireless mouse. A cordless mouse is also called a wireless mouse. We know that nowadays we have a wireless mouse which we can carry around. And that has it has a USB cord attached. We can attach it with a USB cord, and that is the sensing thing in which we can activate the mouse. So connects to a mouse with or without wires. The mouse uses some manner of wireless technology like Bluetooth or infrared waves. RF or infrared waves are used to connect. So I'll explain once more. A cordless mouse is also called a wireless mouse, which connects the computer without any wire. Instead of the mouse, the mouse will be connected to the computer with the Bluetooth or with infrared rays, or we have this type of cords with this type of USB cord, USB port in which we can attach the mouse through this. Now, if you have any doubt, don't worry, I'll make it a point that I'll clear all your doubts. Then we have the optical mouse in which we have the infrared rays and a red light which is used to connect, which is used to see, which uses a light source called the red light under it. This is the light sensing mouse with which we can direct. So we have a light sensing mouse, an optical mouse which uses the light resources under it and through which we can operate the mouse. So that is about the mouse. I'll explain once more. So we have scroll mouse. Scroll mouse in which we have two buttons, left button and the right button, and a scroll wheel in between which helps you to move the screen up and down. Now, Next is about the cordless mouse, which we can carry from one place to another. That is called the cordless mouse. Okay, now this mouse can be used. Okay, it uses the Bluetooth technology. Sometimes it don't have a connector, your USB connector won't be there, so it uses a Bluetooth technology. Sometimes we have a USB connector which is connected with the mouse, or it connects with the light, which is infrared, so that we can get at, it gets connected, like how you do with the TV remote. You know, we can connect the TV remote inside the room, isn't it? Because TV remote has got a red light, which is an infrared light, which sends with the TV panel, which is kept somewhere in the room. So it is in line of contact. That is why we use an infrared rays to communicate. Same we have with mouse also. Mouse will also have a red light, which will communicate with the system. Now, optical mouse. Optical mouse, as I told you earlier, also has a red light, which is an infrared light, which connects the system and the mouse together. Now, let me tell you about joystick. Before I talk, this is too much of talking, isn't it? I hope you guys are becoming a bit like, what to do? So, I'll show you a video of what joystick is. I hope mouse is clear. If you want, I'll repeat again. But is an input device, and it helps you. Joystick has got as you know, it is used for playing games. It has got a stand and a stick. We have two buttons on the top which we can move the image on the joystick. As you all know, you would have gone to the mall and would have played the car game, isn't it? For that, you used a gear which is actually a joystick, in which we can turn the cars on the screen with the help of the gear here, left, right. So that is actually the use of joystick. It has got a base and a stick up in which you can turn it right and left. You can move the image on the screen. So that is the use of joystick. Joystick is again an input device which is used to change the position of the cursor or any object on the screen. And joystick consists of a base and a stick that can be moved in one direction to the other. Slowly or quickly, you can play the games with the help of a joystick. So I'll repeat once more, it is an input device. What is an input device? Joystick, where we can control the movement of the cursor. Like that of the mouse, we can do it with the joystick also. It is used to play images on the screen. We can see that we can play with the cars, isn't it? In the mall, we make the joystick use as a gear, lifting it here, there, we can turn and all. So everything can be done with the help of a joystick. It is an input device which is used to move the objects on the screen. It has got a base and it has got a stick which we can move right, left, everywhere. So that is actually the use of a joystick. Then the next one is about the light pen. Again, I have a video. Let me see it whether 1 minute. Light pen. Yeah, see, this is a use of a light pen. See, they are drawing directly on the screen. Can you all see? See how they are drawing it? See, don't play in between. Just see how they are drawing directly on the screen. See, this is actually the use of a light pen. Now, after doing this, see, they are drawing directly on the screen because it has got some light sensing device which sends the all the pixels on the screen and then it moves. See, we can draw directly, see. Now they are going to animate the image. Can you see? Just wait and watch. Okay. How they are animating the image. See? Oh. We should buy a light pen so that we can also animate images like this. Did you see? See how they animate the image? The last portion we'll repeat and see. The animation part. Come on, play. Nice, isn't it? So this is the use of light pen. Light pen is actually used to draw directly on the screen. So why I'm showing you is you should know the difference. Understood? That is why I'm showing you the light pen and all that. Always I found that students have difficulty in finding the difference between light pen and So light pen is a light sensitive pointing input device. It is a light sensitive pointing input device commonly used to select or modify text. We can draw also. These devices are earlier forms of manipulating and highlighting data on the screen. See, this picture is an example of a woman using a light pen to highlight the text on the screen. Did you see that? She is drawing something, a cube. She is drawing it on the screen. So if you want to highlight something, we can use a light pen. So here also, So the light pen is used to directly draw on the screen. That I, as I told you earlier, we can draw, we can animate. Everything can be done with a light pen. So it is an input device which is used to draw directly on the screen. It is a light sensitive pointing input device. It can sense the, see, like this. It can sense the light. It is a light sensing pointing device which can be used to write on the screen, draw on the screen, everything can be done. We can even highlight the text using a light pen. This is again an example of light pen only. See, we can highlight the text. 1 minute. This is getting highlighted. Okay, so we can highlight. See, I can draw. So a light pen is actually used to draw on the screen. We can draw. See, some people are becoming naughty day by day. See, I can draw it directly on the screen. So this is actually the use of a light pen. It is a light sensitive pointing input device commonly used to select or otherwise modify the text on the screen. These devices are used to directly draw on the screen. We can animate. That is actually the use of a light pen. Then, okay, still we are on the pen note. Okay, now the next one is about the graphic tablet. This is what I want to tell you. There is a difference between light pen and graphic tablet. Graphic tablet is actually used by the artist. They draw on this tablet and it will appear on the screen. Again, I have a video for you. Let me see. See how he is drawing? See, the image is appearing on the screen. This is the use of a graphic tablet. That is why I brought all the videos to show you what is the difference between a light pen and a graphic tablet. See how he is drawing. He is using a graphic tablet and the image is appearing on the monitor. Are you listening? Did you follow? So this is the difference between a graphic tablet and a light pen. See, whatever he is drawing, it is appearing on the monitor. Is it clear? See how he is working. Now, so I hope it is clear. See, the full image I will show you. See, the final image. How beautifully he is drawing. Wow. Actually, this is used by artist people. See. See, so this is the use of, this is the difference between light pen and graphic tablet. Light pen in which we can draw directly on the screen, and graphic tablet in which, like a paper, we draw on the screen, on this tablet, and it will directly appear on the monitor. It is a drawing tablet or a tablet. A graphic tablet is an input device that converts information from a handheld stylus. The user uses stylus like a pen. He can draw. The device can also be used in replacement of a computer mouse. Picture is an example of a graphical tablet. See, I have given an example of a graphical tablet with a mouse. It can be used like a paper. We can draw directly on this graphical tablet what happens? Whatever we draw will appear on the monitor, as I've shown you. So this is actually the use of a graphical tablet. Whatever we draw will appear on the screen. So it is a different device, and light pen is again a different device. I wanted to show you the difference between light pen and graphical tablet. You guys will have a problem with this too. That's why I told you. That's why I brought all the videos for you. Now the next one is scanner. As we all know, scanner is, what is the use of a scanner? It is used to scan the pictures or text, anything that we keep in the scanner. Will scanner will scan it and convert it into a digital form, and it is saved. So a scanner is an input device which converts printed text and graphics into digital form and can be processed and can be saved in the computer. So whatever we give is converted to digital form. Printed text, images, pictures, everything that we kept in the scanner will be converted in digital form, and it is kept in the computer. It works like a photocopy machine. We all know scanner works like a photocopy machine. It can be used to store information. We can transfer information from the paper to the computer hard disk. That is the use. So it is an input device. We have a paper, we can give it to the computers. So what happens is computer will scan that and it will be stored. See, I'll tell you, during your when you reach the 12th, after the practicals, we have a section in which all your marks are being scanned, and this scanned images will go, we'll upload that image. So what happens is that we'll take a printout of your marks, then we'll scan it, and then we'll upload it. So what happens, whatever there in the paper is converted to a digital form. It is kept safe. We can save it, or we can upload it, we can use it in any form, from the paper to the computer. That is actually the use of a scanner. Whatever in there in the paper or photos, from there we can directly copy it to the computer. So it is an input device which is used to convert printed text, graphics into digital form, and can be processed by the computer. Now we have a flat bed scanner, that is which acts like a photocopy machine, which is seen everywhere. Flat bed, which is just like a photocopy machine, in which it copies everything and we can save it. Then we have a handheld scanner also, that is actually used when we go to airports. They will scan our body, isn't it? Okay, they'll through scan our body with the help of a handheld scanner. So they will scan throughout our body. Haven't you all seen that? Now I think even in malls, when we enter the mall, they'll come and they'll check whole our body with the handheld scanners. So scanners are of two types, flatbed and handheld scanners, which is used to scan all our body and all that. So actually, what is the use? It is an input device which is used to convert printed text and graphics in digital form. So scanners are used to convert printed text and graphics into digital form, and we can save it in the computer. So we can give an input and the input is converted into digital form, and it is kept saved in the computer. There are two types of scan. It acts like a photocopy machine. There are two types of scanners: flat bed scanners and handheld scanners. Flat bed scanners act similar to a photocopy machine, where you can take the input, whatever we keep it there, what happens? It is scanned and it is stored as a digital, and it is stored in a digital form inside the computer. So any important informations, we can just scan it and we can store it in the computers. We can store it in the computers. That is actually the use of a flat bed scanner. And as I told you, handheld scanners are used for what? Handheld scanners are used to scan throughout our body if there is any device which we are carrying. For that, we use a handheld scanners. Then we have a magnetic ink character reader. What is the use? Actually, this is an input device which is used to read. See, the magnetic ink which is used in the banks. Even in the ATM, when we keep the ATM cards, the numbers that are printed with magnetic inks, see, that is read by a device. We keep it in a device, isn't it? So they'll read and they'll say, yeah, acknowledged, this person, get in. So that is actually the use of a magnetic ink character recognition. It is a special device which is used for processing bank checks. Then the number codes at the bottom of the checks are written using a special magnetic ink. The magnetic MICRs are used to read these special characters. So it is used to check whether the whatever the checks that we are given is valid or not. The valid checks will have magnetic ink in which the numbers will be written at the end. So it is used to check the validity of a check. So for that only they use what is called a magnetic ink character recognition. It will read those particular lines and it will tell you whether it is a valid check or not. I have brought one video. Let me see here. Magnetic ink character recognition. See this lines. We can see this ones. It is read through this device. Understood? That is the use. So we have a dollar, this letters, it will pass through this, see this letters, will pass through this magnetic ink character recognition and it will tell you whether it is, this letters, they have made it. And see the color, it is written in magnetic, with magnetic ink, that's why it's appearing like this. So these devices are used to read, see, these are used to read this. So magnetic ink character readers are used to, it is used to read these particular numbers which is given at the end of the checks so that we can check whether the check is valid or not. I hope it is clear. Now, so that is the use of magnetic ink character recognition. This is the device which is used to check the whatever written with the magnetic ink, it will read and it will check whether that is a recognized check or not. The characters which are printed at the end can be, we can check the validity of the check using this device. Now the next is about barcode reader. As you all know, barcode reader is very common input device which is used by every people, isn't it? We go to the supermarkets and we'll just check for the barcodes, yes or no? See, even in your pencil, behind the pencil there will be bars, bigger ones and smaller ones. What are they? Actually, they contain the details of the product, the name of the product and the price too. That is why when they used to read this, when they place this device here, what happens? The price will appear. So the details of the product as well as the price will appear. That is all decoded inside it. So when you bring this device to it, what happens? It is then transferred into a form which we can understand and then it will be displayed on the screen. So that is actually the use of barcodes. Barcode contain information about the particular item and the price also. So the barcode is a device which is used to read the barcodes. A barcode is a pattern printed in lines of different thickness that can be seen on many products. We know that almost all products nowadays have barcodes, which interprets these lines to the input information of the product into the computer system. Barcodes are widely used in supermarkets for recording the sales of the item quickly. And we know that when they use this device, it gets decoded and it is then, we can see it in the computer screen, the name of the product as well as the price. So quickly we'll have a review of whatever been taught today. I hope you guys were listening. I'll bring more videos, more useful ones next class, but you have to study. I'm telling you, I'll send you the notes also. Now today I taught you about the pointing device mouse. Mouse was discovered by Douglas Engelbart. Don't forget his name. And mouse, we have two buttons, that is scroll button, and the scroll button is used to What is the use of scroll button? It's used to move the page up and down using the scroll wheels. We have different types of mouses, which is cordless mouse, which we can carry from one place to another, and mouses which are attached with the Bluetooth then, and with infrared waves. Then the optical mouse, as I told you, it works with infrared rays, the light, which connects it with the computer screen. Then we have a joystick, which is again an input device, which is used to play games. It has got buttons on the top. We can move the images or objects on the screen using a joystick. It has got a base and a stand also. See, it has got a base and a stick. Sorry, it's not a stand, a stick, which can move in different directions. After that, we have a light pen. As I told you, it is used to draw directly on the screen, and we can animate also like this. This is a light pen. Then we have a graphic tablet in which we draw on it like that of a paper. Whatever we draw on it will appear on the monitor. That is the use of a graphical tablet. So it is, again, I have shown you all that. Scanner, as we know, it converts whatever which is kept inside will be converted in digital form. Whether it is text or an image or a photo, everything will be converted into digital form and it will be saved. We have two types of scanner. First one is flat bed scanners and handheld scanners. Handheld scanners are actually used to scan, can be used manually to scan the images. A portable device which can be used to copy papers to our computers. Even it is used, as I told you, it is used to scan our body too. They use a handheld scanner only. Here, we can have it with our hand and we can just use at a portable device which is used to scan images and which can be stored in the computer. Then we have what is called a magnetic ink character recognition, which is used to read the characters which are written at the end of the check and check the validity of the checks that we give. Then we have a barcode which is having bars which are written, which have a pattern of lines which has different thickness. These lines has got so many information coded on it. When you bring this device, what happens? It gets decoded and it is then displayed in the computer saying that this is the name of the product and this is the price of the product. This is about the barcodes. It is a device that is used to read barcode. A barcode is a pattern of lines of different thickness. A barcode reads, interprets these lines and gives the information to the computer system. So that is for today.